So, last time, okay, we saw how we can build the storage and then everything that we had, everything that we were gathering, it will have gone and it's going to be placed onto our storage. However, actually, so that we don't wait for them to finish, let's just build a small one over here. And then we're going to cut some trees or whatever. Okay, so lumberjack, let's copy any of this. Okay, so what we did, however, I'm kind of not quite happy, as you can see, that we are placing the tiles based on this, and we are sending the character, the units, onto the closest storage tile. Which means if you have like a huge area, then you will getting this tile and it will have been placed onto that. So we're going to manage a few things with our materials in this one. And let's go onto our material database. And the first thing I want to also add is I'm going to create a public game object. We have the material prefab, which just visualizes this material prefab. We also want to have a material in a raw format. So, okay, material raw prefab. And the material raw prefab is basically if you cut down a tree, how it's going to look. This can be a sprite, this can be a 3D object. We're going to do all of that for this one. So, let's go find the logic that gathers materials. So let's see. We have drop resources task. Okay, which goes and adds the material on the storage. Okay. Let's see. Gather resources task. And let's remember this a little bit how it's going. We assign a unit. Of course, play animation. Okay, and on finish, we find the closest storage block. This is going to change. This will have to change. And then we go and assign storage block as that. And we send the character on the storage block. While we are in here, we can assign the unit, I think from the unit itself. Or we can just do this in here as well. So we have our unit. We have current material. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to create a new game object. And let's see. Yeah, okay. Game object, instantiate. We have to use the game object first because our class doesn't derive from mono behavior. Okay, and I believe it doesn't also derive from a scriptable object. Okay. So, instantiate unit carrying material, material raw prefab as game object. On that game object, we can parent it underneath our unit dot transform, and we can also reset its position. And let's set a new one actually. Let's say 0. Let's put it 1 point up, like it's kind of moving it. Okay, so we need to kind of save this as well, otherwise we won't be able to remove it. And on our unit pick definition, we can go and the same way we are doing the carrying material, we can just say public game object carrying object. Okay, carrying object, then unit dot carrying object will be the game object we have. If there's no storage block, we're going to just drop it where we are. So unit dot carrying object dot transform dot parent will be null, and unit dot carrying object dot transform dot position, we can just assign it on the current block we are in. Current block dot, I guess, world position, but I think we will have to add it a little bit. We will either have to add the offset, or we will have to add, you know, we will have to find the upper block instead of our current block. We'll see what this does, and we'll see then what we're doing. So, drop resources task, storage block dot block, okay. Let's go over here, and instead of finding the closest storage block, I want to create a material database, and actually I'm going to create blocks per the materials that we're using. So we're going to have a simple storage block that is going to hold 10 wood or whatever, and we're also going to have a storage block that will hold then something else. Okay. And when that is filled, then we're going to be assigning a new storage block and a new storage block and so on and so on. So we have our storage block. Now we're going to have to assign those ones, the new ones. And instead of looking through our entire storage blocks, we're going to first look for blocks that have a material in them. Let's take a peek what we have in here. We already have a block, we already have material count, and we have the max material count. Then we're going to assign my material. Okay. And we're going to go through our entire storage blocks, and we're going to say if we actually, let's pass as well the my material, target material. And for, we're going to have to create a list of available storage blocks. This might not be the most optimized way to do this, but we can fix that later. Okay, we don't have to worry for that. Available storage. Yeah, okay, available storage. Okay, it's going to be a new list. Then we're going to do storage blocks dot count, and if storage blocks I dot my material equals the target material. Okay, and if storage blocks I dot material count is lower than storage block I dot the maximum material count, then it's going to be available storage. Okay, we add that onto storage blocks I and so on. This will first look for the materials we have. Okay, I'm also going to create a list for the empty ones, empty storage, empty storage block, and if I'm going to do an else if over here, and if the storage blocks I dot my material is empty, we haven't yet assigned something yet. Okay, so like that, and we need, okay, then we're going to add it as an empty storage, add storage blocks I. Okay, so we now have two lists. We have the available storages and the empty storages, which means we can just find the closest one we have, which is going to be the available storage. The thing is, we don't necessarily need to look for more than one. Okay, but if you want to find the closest one, although you know what, there's no need to find the closest one, so screw that. So I'm going to take this, and if we find a storage block, target block, let's assign that to null. Well, okay, we have the return value, but I'll do it differently. Okay, I'm going to say target block equals the storage blocks we have over here. Okay, and we're going to do a break. We don't need to run the rest of our for int. We already found our target block, so we can delete this one. Okay, then let's remove that. We can say if storage blocks, or if target block is null, then target block assign the first one you have on your empty storage. The first one that is also going to be inside this list. The only issue with this is that we might not have any more empty storages. So we can say if empty storage.count is higher than zero, then only then assign the target block, which can also be return value is the same one as the target block. Okay, and this, we don't need this, the minimum distance anymore. We could actually just remove the return value as well, I guess. So let's do that. Then target block. And we can rename this instead of get closest storage block, get closest storage block or assign one. Okay, we have one error, final references, and yeah, the error, we can find the error from view error lists. Okay, because we also need to pass the material we have from here, and that will be unit.carrying material. And we need to rename this to get closest storage block or assign one. Okay, so save that. Okay, so let's go now, and we have to assign what the materials are going to look on the primal form. And yeah, okay, let's do some stuff like this. And okay, let's say this is tree row, and I'm just going to create 3D object. I think we are using a capsule. Yeah, okay, let's use a capsule. Remove the capsule collider. I'm going to add it in here. Let's rotate it 30 degrees and maybe make it a little bit smaller, just so that we don't confuse it with the rest. So back onto our data. Let's see, material database. Tree row. Okay, we have a tree prefab. I'm going to assign this over here. You know what? For the other material, let's assign the same one because we don't really care for this. Now, one small other thing we need to change is when we are actually dropping our resources, we're not going to create a new one, as we can see over here, add material on storage. We're not going to create a new, just another object. I'm just going to say my material dot material raw prefab, and we're going to instantiate that. Okay, as game object. Also, minimize that and let this compile. Load and let's build. Let's make this guy start building. Yeah, maybe this one is going to give us an issue, so let's destroy that part. Let's destroy those two. Well, I actually wanted to destroy the ones above anyway. Let's maybe build. Okay, and let's go cut some trees. Okay, we got our first. Okay, so we have the error. But why do we have the error? I think we have the error because we never assigned the carrying material. At least as far as I'm seeing over here, I'm not assigning this. So where is getting assigned? Add material on storage. Game object and storage block. Okay, so we never assigned that, which means we can just do unit.carryingMaterial equals target block dot my material. Was that? And let's try again. Hit load. Okay, let's do a small build. And let's go with lumberjacks. Okay, cut some stuff from here. Only one guy went though, so that's strange. Okay, you can see that they now carry the materials. Of course, you can add anything you want with this. And everyone is going over there. Now, here's what we're going to do. Instead of doing this, like we still keep and we do instantiate more than we need to, we can just take the same amount of the same material. Let's see how we're going to do this. Okay, we get this and then on drop resources task, add material on storage. I'm going to do pick definition and I'm going to pass the unit as well, which also means we don't need the my material. We can just pass the unit. And I'm doing a definition on the definition itself, okay? Happens to the best of us. Okay, so the final references. Instead of my material, we're going to say unit. Add material storage, okay. And this one will be unit as well. And then inside here, we're going to say unit, instead of instantiating, because we don't need to instantiate this, we're going to say unit dot carrying object dot, well, carrying object, just that. We don't have to create it again or destroy the old ones because we already have the wood object. Okay, so let's do another build. So with this, we kind of get a little bit more, you know, advanced of, yeah, for whatever reason, they can't find the path onto this line. As you can see, our world generation kind of have some issues. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to try and test the other cases for this. So I'm going to do a lumberjack without having any storage so we can see what's going to happen. Okay, nothing happens. They do keep it onto themselves again. Yeah, okay. So transform parent, if you set it to null, we also need to parent it under on the same chunk, otherwise we lose them. Okay, that's one thing to do. Let's go and do that. On to the gather resource task. Instead of transform parent equals null, that will be unit.currentBlock.chunk.object. Dot transfer. Okay, so they will follow us around. And vector 3 dot up, I think we don't need this. Okay. Awesome. So let's minimize that. And I'm going to build only one unit of storage space. Or actually, let's build a little bit more than one. Let's find where we have some trees or something. More than one trees. Okay, so we're going to create four of them. And we're going to go and cut all these trees and see where are they going to place them. And what's going to happen when they run out of space? Let's carry all of this. Yeah, only one guy went though. So let's do it like this. So we get the entire thing. As you can see, we can carry our trees. Go and place them. They kind of place them randomly. We don't reset our rotation. And you can see that because we have that, because we have also the management on how many materials you can have, they just assign a new one. So with that, if we go and place some stones now. So yeah, I think this was an issue. Stones didn't actually work like that. They placed it on the same storage block. Let's see. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this, I'm going to duplicate this, I'm going to make this stone or whatever, stone row. I'm going to assign this down here, and then on the iron material, I'm going to assign the stone row. The iron is not missing on me, don't worry. And art, let's copy one of these. Let's make this a stone. Okay. Oops. Okay, no, it's a correct. Apply. Delete. Let's assign this as, let's make a new wood. Let's make it a little bit more light. Let's replace that. Zero. Okay. Paste that. And we can just assign the same ones, I guess, on the items. On these two. So, cylinder, let's replace that to wood 2. And tree prefab, open that up, capsule. And yeah, that's the stone. The cylinder was a stone anyway. Let's do that. And let's use stone. Or wood one. Okay, so we have a little bit more visual thing. Of course, you can just use sprites with this, but I don't have any handy. Okay, so yeah, I don't know what this is. Forget it. So let's do a build over here. Four of them down here. And let's do a lumberjack operation. Okay, so this will give us one extra where we're going to place two trees and it's going to have one left, one stone left. Okay, let's do stone cutter then and let's see where they're going to assign that stone. Yeah, this is wrong. So the material check is actually wrong in this case. Let's see, serialized object has been destroyed. What? Let's see what we're doing over here. Current block. Target material. Oh, yeah, I know what it is. Because we never assigned the material to this. Pull the storage block. So, target block dot my material is going to be the target material. Let it compile and I think we're probably done with this. It load. Let's build. Let's build only two of them. Let's cut only these three. And maybe this one as well. Actually, no, we don't need to cut this another tree. We can just use stone cutter. And depending on where it's going to place that stone. Damn it. Why is that? Storage locks, I. Yeah, so this, for whatever reason, this didn't work. Oh, yeah, I know what. This actually needs to go away from there and add material on storage. Need to check for this one first of all. Add material on storage, and we have our storage blocks. Material count, max material count. Yeah, no, some of this is actually wrong because we were finding the first object we can, the first block we have. So instead of doing any of that, we're just going to say add material on storage. Let's do. No, this is recursive because we already checked if we have one of these. Just going to comment all of this out, and I'm going to say let's find the first case we are using it. Okay, we have unit, we also have the target block, so we can pass that block as well. Pick definition. Block, target block, target block, add material storage. Actually, wait, no, we didn't get an error. Okay, and we basically need this storage blocks. We don't want any of that, of course. Target block. Oh, we need a storage block. So, yeah, okay, so let's go back. Final references. Material storage. And I'm going to create a public storage block. Storage block, and I'm going to be passing the storage block instead of the target block. Add material storage, storage block with an S. Okay, then let's find this. Okay, okay, so to let's find where B, what B is, and B is the actual block which we can just get from block B equals target block dot block. We have our wall position. Okay, depending on how many items we have, we place it above. We parent that onto our transform, and I think only thing we have left is assigning the storage index plus plus. No, the material count. So that will be target block dot material count plus plus. We can assign this, actually, instead of assigning this over here, and then we can go back onto, well, where we first create the drop resources down here. Okay, and we need to now assign the storage block, and we have to do that when we first create that, which is onto, this is actually the gather resources task, this is the scriptable object. Okay, so down here we find our storage block. Okay, if it's not null, then we can just say on the storage block dot material count plus plus, and on the drop you have storage block equals the storage block. Okay, save that, minimize, and Let's hit play. Let's do a build. Something like that. And let's cut one tree. This will be the lucky one. And then we're going to cut also one stone. Let's see where they're going to place it. And now this should not place it on the same position. Yeah, the difference between Sulden and Sulden, I guess it's much greater than I thought for these guys. So, get closest turrets on block, okay. And yeah, I think we forgot to assign this one. So that will be target block dot my material equals target material. Okay, I think this will be the last time I'll test this. If it doesn't, then I'm just going to fix it offline. As you can see, we're only adding a line here and there. Let's create two. I guess we. Yeah, okay. We have some stone over there. I guess we could just create only one. And then if he doesn't place it on that one, then if he drops the resources down, then that will mean that it's assigned as the correct one. Yeah, okay, so that was it, it works. Let's test what happens if we start gathering a lot more than we have storage spaces. I think this will just drop it. And with that, I believe we have almost, yeah, I think we have completed with this part. And there we have an error. Let's see why. Because we are missing a target block. Yeah, because you can't find a target block. So, else, target block. Okay. Otherwise, you're just going to return null and we handle the case. What happens if it's null, which is of course down here. So let's hit play. And now I'm just not going to create any build. I'm not going to create any storage spaces. I'm just going to gather. And once it gathers, yeah, they didn't find any. They didn't find any on the level. We're only checking on one level, of course. Okay, and they just drop them there. And if they can move, the resources stays there. And if we go around the map, not right now, it does a little bit of jumping because we don't have any threading. Okay, and there we go. Our resources stays in place as they should. Awesome. You can see when the map changes, we're going through the other side of the map because the indicators are not parented under any object. That's why they go on and off. Anyway, let's finish this part. As always, you know what to do. Like, subscribe if you like to see more stuff like this. Of course, consider supporting my Patreon so we can keep making a lot more like this. I'll see you next time.